3 Jammu and Kashmir armed police personnel died, 14 were injured after 2 terrorists attacked a police bus near a police camp in Zewan on the outskirts of Srinagar this evening. The attack took place at a highly secure area that houses several camps of various security forces, according to media reports. The terrorists unleashed heavy firing at the 9th Battalion of the Indian Reserve Police and fled. Viral images of the bus that was attacked has been shared on social media. The area has been cordoned off and search and rescue operations are on. All injured personnel were evacuated and taken to various hospitals for treatment. Prime Minister Narendra Modi witnessed the Ganga Aarti from Swami Vivekananda cruise in Varanasi today. Shiv Deepotsav is being celebrated today in the city. In the morning, the Prime Minister inaugurated the Kashi Vishwanath corridor in Varanasi. He lauded the civilizational heritage of Varanasi, saying sultanates rose and fell over the years, but the holy city of Kashi has withstood the test of time. The Prime Minister has been on an inauguration spree ahead of the assembly polls in Uttar Pradesh next year. Trinamool Congress Rajya Sabha MP Mausam Noor filed a privilege motion against ex-CJI Ranjan Gogoi after an NDTV interview in which he had said, and I quote, "I go to the Rajya Sabha when I feel like it, when I think there are matters of importance on which I should speak. I am a nominated member, not governed by any party whip." Gogoi had cited the COVID curbs and lack of proper social distancing as reasons why he doesn't attend Parliament. At least 10 other parliamentarians from different parties are expected to move similar motions. A complete shutdown was observed in Ladakh to press for the demand of statehood. The region was carved out as a separate union territory in August 2019 from the erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir. This is the first time when the leadership in Muslim-majority Kargil and Buddhist-dominated Leh have joined hands for their political future. The Bandh call was given by a Leh-based apex body which represents various social, religious and political groups in Leh and the Kargil Democratic Alliance. At least one person has died in Britain after being infected with the Omicron variant. Prime Minister Boris Johnson said on Monday as the country launched an ambitious COVID booster shot program to stop the virus's spread. Britain, among the countries worst hit by the global health crisis since last year, is believed to be the first government to officially announce a death from the virus mutation.